Hi friends, greetings to one and all. Welcome to Aero Study Circle. If you want to see our daily updated videos, subscribe our YouTube channel Aero Study Circle. In this video, we are going to see one topic, that's indices theory and problem. Okay, it's especially for BCom, BCom CA. Become banking students. Okay, so indices, first of all, what do you know about indices? That's nothing but if n is a positive integer, if n is a positive integer and a is a real number, then the product a dot and so on n times, okay, a into and so on n times is denoted by a power n. It's denoted by a power n. Here A is called the base, here A is called the base and N is called the index of the power. Okay, first of all, here A dot A and so on N times, it's denoted by A power N. Here A is base and N is called index of that power. Okay. So next we are going to see some few properties of indices. Okay, so first law, A power N into a power n, that can be written as a power m plus n. Okay, in few slides we are going to see the proof of that results. So first of all, we are going to see the results. Okay, so second result, a power m divided by a power n, that's equal to a power m minus n, a power m minus n if m greater than n, if m greater than n. So next result, a power m divided by a power n, that's equal to 1 divided by a power n minus n if n greater than m, if n is greater than n. So next result, a power m whole power n, a power m whole power n, that can be written as a power m into n, not like that, a power m n, a power m n. So next result, AB whole power n is equal to A power n B power n, A power n into B power n. Okay, so then the law A power m into A power n is equal to A power m plus n. That means the first law is called, okay, that's nothing but the first law is called fundamental law of index, fundamental law of index. So next one, proof of that first law, proof of a power m dot a power n is equal to a power m plus n. We are going to prove this result. Here a power m equal to a dot and so on m times. Okay, a dot a and so on m times. Here a power m is equal to a dot and so on m times. Therefore, a power m into a power n, a power m into a power n. Here a is m times, here a is n times. Therefore, totally a is m plus n times. Therefore, a is m plus n times. Here a is m plus n times. That can be written as a power m plus n. Okay, a power m plus n. We are going to prove this result. Okay, we proved a power m dot a power n is equal to a power m plus n. Okay, it's our first result. So second one, a power m divided by a power n is equal to a power m minus n if m is greater than n. So another result, we are going to prove this result. For that, we are taking a power m divided by a power n. A power m is equal to a into a and so on m times. A power n can be written as a dot and so on n times. Therefore, it's m times, this one is n times, therefore a power m minus n times, it can be written as a minus n times. That means a power m, here a power n, since m is greater than n, so therefore a dot and so on m minus n times. That means a power a, as per previous result, a and so on, this is m times, okay, this is m times. So denominator, a power, sorry, multiplication, into e power minus 1, e power minus 1 and so on n times, okay, and so on n times. So therefore here m times, as per first law, a m times a power minus 1 n times, that means a minus n times, okay, a power minus n times. So a m times, here a power minus n times, therefore it a power m minus n, okay, a power m minus n, it's the second result. So third one, we are going to prove this result. A power m divided by a power n is equal to 1 divided by a power n minus m if n greater than n. So that's nothing, but a power m can be written as a into and so on m times. Here a power n can be written as and so on n times, can be written as 1 divided by a power n minus m. Since n is greater than m, n is larger than m, so it can be written as a dot and so on m times. It becomes a power, for example, consider this one, a dot m times, it can be written as a power minus 1, this m times, this one is m times, denominator already is there, a dot and so on n times, okay, it's n times. So totally a power minus n times. So as per first law, a power minus n, a power n, it can be written as a power n minus m, can be written as a power n minus m, okay, that's our result, okay. So next result, proof of a power m whole power n, that's equal to a power m into n, okay, a power m into n. So a power m into n is equal to a power m n times, a power n m into a power m into and so on n times. It can be written as a power m plus m plus, so if you add base or equal means we have to add, okay, base or equal means we have to add, that's nothing but a power m plus a power e, m plus m plus m plus and so on n times, that can be written as a power m n, okay, a power m n, okay, these are the results. This one is the last result, a b whole power n is equal to a power n into b power n. We are going to prove this result. So a b whole power n can be written as a b dot a b and so on n times. Next one, it's a number, that's no problem, we are splitting this number a dot and so on n times, okay, a dot and so on n times, and b dot and so on n times. So that can be written as a power n into b power n, okay. So it's the some properties of laws of indices. So next one, few more results. So what about meaning of a power 0? What do you know about a power 0? Anything power 0 is equal to 1. We are going to prove this result. So now we are, okay, a power m into a power 0, we are going to find the value of a power 0. For that we are writing like this, a power m dot a power 0 is equal to a power m plus 0, okay, as per first law. So a power m plus 0, m plus 0 is nothing but m, okay, we are going to find the value of a power m. So now we are going to cancel on both sides a power m, so therefore a power 0 is equal to 1, okay, therefore a power 0 is equal to 1. So next one, meaning of a power minus m, we are going to find the value of a power minus m. Here m is a positive integer, here m is a positive integer. So for that, a power m into a power minus m, okay, we are going to find the value of a power m. So therefore can be written as a power, as per first law, a power m into a power n can be written as a power m plus n, using that law, a power m minus m. So what about m minus m? That's equal to 0. So from the previous result, what we know about a power 0? A power 0 is nothing but 1. So from this, we have to find the value of a power minus m. So a power minus m is equal to 1 divided by a power m. Okay, a power minus m is equal to 1 divided by a power m. Okay. Thank you, friends.